Hey, welcome to the campus of the UAA ISU Doctor of Pharmacy program located here in Anchorage, Alaska. We're so excited to show you our facilities today. We have been here for 4 years. This is a collaborative program with Idaho State University and the University of Alaska Anchorage to bring the Doctor of Pharmacy degree to the state of Alaska, which is the last state in the union to not have a Doctor of Pharmacy program. We have also partnered with the Alaska Pharmacist Association so that our students, as they join the program, are members of this prestigious association here in Alaska, which has been a leader in the industry for many, many years. I'm going to take you around and show you our facilities. They are sized appropriately for our Alaska cohort. These students are a part of a bigger cohort of students in Idaho. They receive their curriculum here on the Anchorage campus. They spend all 4 years of the Doctor of Pharmacy program right here in Alaska. They never leave the state. The first 3 years are spent here on campus doing their coursework through a very sophisticated high-tech delivery system we call our synchronous distance delivery, where the students receive lectures from the three different campuses, but they receive them all at the same time. So a student may be in Pocatello, Meridian, or Anchorage, Alaska, and they, depending on where the lecture originates, that's where the live lecture will be, but they all receive the lecture at the same time. Some students will receive it from a big screen, and some will have a lecturer right in front of them. We also have a very interactive virtual environment with high definition cameras. We admit 15 students a year, and our classrooms, you'll see, are situated to hold 20 students. So we do have a capacity to grow, but we will grow commensurate with the job demand and the job market as the state grows and as we see the healthcare industry grow. So okay, off we go to our tour. Well, let me start the tour with our administrative offices. You can see our sign here. And as you come in here, we've got a reception area for the folks who are visiting with us. Our program director, Chris Jackson, she is a wonderful asset to our team and invaluable in the development of the program. Dr. Renee Robinson's office, she's actually a research pharmacist and a fellow trained pediatric pharmacist, and been a wonderful asset here to the campus. This is actually where the assistant dean for Alaska programs resides. This is a synchronous distance delivery that's actually scaled down. Particularly, we use this just for meetings to connect with the leadership teams and the student groups to commemorate the founding of the Doctor of Pharmacy program here in Alaska. It was actually a wonderful event. This is hanging in every campus. As we exit the building, this takes us up campus. It's a nice spring day. And I say spring, it's about 45 degrees, but this is as much sunlight as we've seen in a long time. It's called the Quad. We're still on lower campus, but I want to give you some aspect of what the students experience when they're here. You can see we've got a big presence in this building. And we've got our sign and our mission statement, very similar to what you'll see on the other campuses with the program. We're going to take you first to the student lounge. Every student has a key to this building and a key to this room, as required by accreditation, so that they have 24/7 access to their study lounge. And you can see we've got some real live students here. Say hi, Daniel.
Hi.
We have one of our P3s here. You can see they have all the amenities that they would need. As we move away from the lounge, we have a partition that actually separates the lounge into a what we call our case studies room. So we will do small group work here. We'll also do some IPE type activities here. We have the ability to connect through our DL system here. We also have a couple of faculty members here, Dr. Ratliff, who is a critical care pharmacist over at Alaska Regional, and also Dr. Amy Paul, who is an ambulatory care pharmacist at Providence Medical Group, one of our partner systems, also a wonderful addition to our faculty. And we're gonna head into this AV room to the back end of what we call the P1 room. And you can see we've got some classroom activity going on. It looks very familiar. We modeled this after the Meridian and Pocatello sites. This is the P1 class. Say hello, P1 class.
Hello.
Thanks, P1s. Down this hallway, this is where we house some of our posters. We actually have many more posters of student research projects that they've done here in Alaska. They're taken down in preparation for research day. I think they've been moved around. This takes us to our compounding room. This is the drug dosage form and design lab. And this is a full lab. Hey, P2s. So, Lauren, tell us your name and where you're from and why you're in pharmacy school.
Um,
I'm Lauren Ta. Everybody calls me Lore. I'm from Anchorage, Alaska.
Why did you come to pharmacy school?
Because it's fun. You learn about the body and what drugs do to your body.
That's awesome. Daniel Enox.
Hi.
Okay, one thing about the Anchorage campus that no other pharmacy student would see on campus.
Well, first, we're a small campus, and we're in a pretty rural state by definition, so we actually can make a huge impact.
P3 room. Hey, Janelle, what's cool about this is you can actually see the students in Meridian. They're also studying.
My name is Corey. I'm a third-year pharmacy student. I moved here from Kodiak, Alaska, and my husband and I commercial fish there in the summer, and I'm here studying pharmacy, third year.
Hi, my name is Hannah. I'm a third-year student. I'm a CPI intern student that I've had an opportunity to work with an antimicrobial stewardship pharmacist over at the hospital across the street, and it's been a great resource and opportunity for me to learn from him and do projects about C. diff or penicillin allergies and interventions that the pharmacists make. And I've been doing that for the past 3 years.
Some of the pharmacy students actually ride their fat bikes to school. Been doing this all year long. You can see the studs on the tires. And you'll notice that's not water in that water bottle holder. Well, that concludes the tour. We have an excellent program here. You can see that the students are well cared for. And we go to great lengths to make sure that their opportunities here in Alaska are commensurate with the same opportunities that they have in Idaho.
Class of 22, we rock.
Class of 22, we rock, that's right. So we had this set up with different stations for some high school students to come and practice making a geometric dilution exercise. And you can see it's a little bit greasy. Some of them did better than others.